previously on Chilling.
Say, man is the only maker of his own destiny. And when it comes to longevity, it is something in this cooking business that everybody strives to get. Now you won't believe who I have today. And everybody has a story to tell. Chef Frank is here with me tonight. How are you, man?
I'm okay, guys.
Now, I must confess, I've always pronounced you with one name.
A gentleman walked from Mexico to Uganda and reached in Kampala. American, very tall, huge. And he had a paper, the Sani, but it was just a piece of paper. Then as he entered the restaurant, I walked out with my food. Gentleman was like, he is the one. That's the guy. You know, I almost dropped the plates down. I was like, what have I done? Then the guy followed me aggressively, physically. He was like, okay. He was like, you are the one. Remember me? I was like, I can't remember you.
Because you feed a lot of people.
Yes. And here the guy goes to his bag, pulls out the Sani with my picture on it. It's like, are you not the one? I said, yeah, I cannot remember.
Chilling.
My name is Drago and I'm the host of Chilling, and I'm asking you, my friend, to keep the love coming on YouTube, Facebook and Twitter. That is Chilling UBC TV.
Chilling.
Good evening, Uganda, and welcome to the show. My name is Drago. Now, today is a big, big day for the show because we have one of the greatest comedians in Africa. Now, life for Kenneth didn't start off with the glamour and fame of performing comedy. However, even back then, he knew that he had a talent to share with the world. Now, in an effort to pay that forward, he hosted his own show called Pablo Life. Let's go have a chat with him.
Chilling.
We are back at Deep and Sip on Kafo Road. Now guys, also remember to follow our Facebook page and Twitter handle. That is Chilling Space UBC TV. Now, I think the wait is almost done. It's time for me to let the cat out of the bag. I'm going to introduce my guest. Now, my guest is no stranger to the limelight. His career started in 2004. As a pioneer at the Theatre Factory. Since then, he has had an illustrious career. He's also the winner of the Mnet Africa stand-up competitions. Now, every single time I say his name, Pablo, it always bubbles me with laughter. Guys, let's give it up for the incredible and host of the Pablo Live Show, Mr. Pablo! How are you, man?
Awesome.
Did you like my introduction?
It was amazing. I mean, it was the real deal Khashoggi de Magwan.
How are we? Before we started the show, you confessed about the traffic.
Ooh,
yeah, Kampala traffic
you,
is horrible.
I tell you, the traffic, I think you can cook beans in that jam before you get where you're going. It's extremely annoying.
What?
But yeah, I mean, such challenges are what make life interesting.
You spent almost, tell me, 1 hour and a half.
One and a half hours.
Coming.
From Ntenda to Deep and Sip.
What? Yeah?
Can you imagine? But thankfully, I you know there's always compensation. Mm. When I walked into this space, Deep and Sip, yes, you might think this place has been plucked out of a magazine. You
beautiful.
It's just awesome.
This one looks like a screensaver or something.
You, Deep and Sip, believe you me, I'm going to be a usual suspect here.
Funny man, how are you doing, Pablo?
Okay, life is good.
Now, this is when I stop you right there. Yeah. A year, almost years ago, you had this I'm okay syndrome, or I'm doing fine. Oh, Maggie has brought your tea.
Ah, time to appease the stomach of good ones, huh?
Yeah, it's okay. Maggie's coming.
I'm okay, happiness is killing me.
This is African tea, I'm sure. Maggie's.
African tea spice.
And gonja?
African tea spice. This is cow juice.
Thank you, Maggie. Yes, you can go now.
Thank you so much. Wow, so I appreciate your hospitality.
Pablo, yeah? About years ago, you had this confessing to this syndrome of people saying, I'm fine.
Yeah.
And you say they don't say it with too much conviction.
Yeah, honestly.
Now I'm stopping you right there. If I asked you before, how are you? And you said, I'm fine.
I said, awesome.
No. I stand corrected. You said I'm fine.
I'm fine.
Yeah, but what caused you say that? Like, a lot of people don't actually say and they mean it.
I think the thing about I'm fine is something that they give us a full dose of I'm fine when we're growing up. We're indoctrinated into the culture of saying I'm fine even when you're not fine. How are you? I'm fine. So try it even when you go to a hospital and you find a person on a drip. Ask them, how are you? They'll say, I'm fine. Even if a person... it's something that we're taught, and so we just adapted. But believe you me, if a person, if you want to know somebody's real emotion, ask them, how are you? They'll say, I'm fine. Ask them again, how are you? They'll say, yeah, I'm fine. Then you say, how are you? I'm fine, but things are tough. So how are you? Man, do you have 10,000? Just greet them around four times.
Yeah.
You'll see the real truth.
Chilling.
Your real name is Kenneth Kimuli.
Yes, please.
Tell me, how did this persona of Pablo start?
That's a very good question. In 2000... Oh, thank you.
Let me pause for you.
In 2003, I started working on a radio station. And the program's director didn't like my name, Kenneth. She felt it wasn't radio-like. So I said, well, you can give me any other name as long as the paycheck comes through.
What?
The first name she gave me was Mendez.
May what?
Mendez.
A Mexican?
Yeah. I don't know why she was so...
How many spoons?
Two. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
And so... I went on air and I said, you're listening to this radio station and this is yours truly, Mendez. The number to call is 041-433-2020. Give me a buzz, let's talk. And guess what? The first caller came up and said, hello, Mandazi. I went back and told the lady, nobody's going to call me Mandazi. So she said, okay, what name can we give you? And then she gave me another Spanish name, Ricardo. I said, who are we calling that name? I myself, by the time...
Why was she focusing on Mexico?
She was reading. I realized she was reading.
You look like one of the Spanish guys.
I think I look like a drug lord. She was reading a magazine. I think it was a Spanish thing. She said, okay, let's call you Pablo. And when I went on air, I said, yo, this is truly Pablo. Give me a bell, yo, let's rock. And the name stuck. So the people who used to come and watch us at National Theater, by then it was a theater factory. They said, but you sound like Pablo on radio. I said, yeah, I'm the one who does that segment of Pablo. I said, you're Pablo.
Yeah.
So that's how Pablo was born. And it has stuck up to this day to a point that even some of my legal documents, the name is inscripted there.
No way.
Yeah.
No way.
Some people...
Like your passport has Kenneth Kimuli Pablo?
No. My passport was there before I got the name, but at times when I'm signing contracts, I find when they are written in public, I say, guys, this is not a legal name. This is just a pseudonym. It's just a nickname.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, it's amazing. And I must appreciate your vibrant in person. By the way, I'm a fanatic fan of the Pablo Life Show. What happened to that?
It's still on. You realize that since 2009 till 2016, we had never taken a break. So last year, my team and I said, you know what? We need to first take a break. The ego's approach. You know the ego approach?
No.
When an ego grows old, or when it reaches a point that it's not as strong as it was, it flies to the mountains. That's why they live longer. It flies to the mountains, plucks off its old nails, breaks its beak, so that a new one can grow.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a painful process it goes through, but it comes back stronger than ever after some time. So we said we need to take off some time and, you know, re-strategize, because also the dynamics are changing, the audience is changing, our target audience, and things are changing. We're now in the technology world. We need to readjust. And the plus to that, we also got a space. We were privileged to get a space. We are turning into an art center.
Yeah.
Tangaza Art Center. It's in a place called Muganza Wongererwa. But people know it as Chikumi, the Makere.
Yeah.
So we are.
Oh, it's closer to my home.
Yeah. So we are putting up an art center where we can mentor young people in the arts, in comedy, public speaking,
wow,
script writing.
Wow.
But it's also, there's a campaign I'll be talking to you about later, where we have young people who are HIV positive.
Yes.
And we are creating a space for them, show them that this is not the end, so that we can empower them with more skills and also prepare them to fly on their wings regardless of their serious status.
Yeah, because I remember very properly. We shall talk about this another week.
Absolutely.
Chilling.
As you're going to enjoy your tea, oh, before you do that, let us first play a game.
Uh-huh.
It's called the concentration game. I love this
the
game.
The concentration game, as I'm taking with you.
No, before you take your tea, because you might choke on that tea,
okay,
my brother.
Let's keep on
this game is known for the faint-hearted.
Yeah.
Concentration. Names of female artists. Start.
Alicia.
Juliana.
Hey.
You say one, I say one. So
you see,
whoever loses the face.
Okay, you know me, I passed exams by retakes. So
whoever loses focus takes a sip of that water. That means you've lost. So we must keep a, you know, that reciprocational pace.
Yeah, thank God I'm
fasting. Da. You will take that and we'll bring more water. You think it's a joke? Concentration. Words that begin with letter L. Laugh.
Lord.
Zipu. Okay, you next.
You sound like one of those tribes that have a problem with L and R.
No, I was going to say leave, but I don't know what happened.
Concentration. Animals which begin with L.
Lion.
Leopard.
Listen. Guys, come on, help me out.
Animals which begin with L apart from that.
So I've lost. I sip again.
It's you sip.
Concentration. Names of ministries in Uganda. Minister of Gender.
Minister of Health.
Minister of Trade.
Minister of Labour.
Minister of Foreign Affairs.
Minister of Housing.
Minister of Public Service.
Minister of Defence.
Ministry of...
At least we don't vote for you.
Last time I began with that, I don't know why it failed. Okay, you win.
Uh-huh.
Why are you winning me? You must be a smart one.
Uh-huh. All right, here we go. Concentration.
Concentration, Pablo.
Concentration.
Don't open your eyes, boy. You're scaring me. Don't open your eyes. You're scaring me. Concentration, shoot.
Name of capital cities.
Kampala.
Dar es Salaam.
Nairobi.
Cairo.
Cape Town.
Djibouti is the country.
Save, my brother, save. Losing at your own fate. See.
Right.
The last one. Concentration.
Concentration.
Names of restaurants in Kampala. Deep and Sip. No, you can't
There's
say.
There's no other restaurant better than the Deep and Sip. There's no other restaurant. Deep and Sip is Deep and Sip.
I wish manager Del had that.
Yes, Deep and Sip is Deep and Sip. Yes.
Pablo, you're crazy, man. Okay, now I give up. You're crazy.
Chilling.
We are going to talk about anger. Something we find in the limbic part of the brain. It's actually a feeling that is so much antagonizing and also good at the same time. Why is anger a good thing at the same time?
I think for me, I should say that every human being has an understandable degree of anger. But it entirely depends on how you deal with it. First of all, it entirely depends on people's temperaments. What's your temperament? And how, also that leads you to know how you deal with anger. And for me, I believe that anger is something that you can deal with. But depending on, you have to pay attention to your levels of anger. Like I said, everybody has an understandable degree of anger, and it's justifiable because we are human. But how you deal with it is what determines the level. How you deal with it. Others say, well, it could be genetic. The genes and chromosomes determine the anger, but I think, regardless of the fact that you might come from, I've seen people say that my family, we are hot tempered. Our temper can even boil rice. You see, may I believe no matter how hot your temper is, it can't boil rice.
Because you have to think about the consequences.
You have to deal with it, you have to deal with anger.
Yeah.
And for me, there are people, if you want to know anger, ask people who have been married. Because in marriage, there's always an opportunity. You know, some people say that marriage is like the Middle East, it has no solution. Yeah, but yes, it depends on how each marriage has its own template. But that's why you find when you go to, there are three things that will always cause anger.
Yes.
Three things.
Yeah.
One, money.
Being rejected.
Rejection.
Mm.
Yeah? Money.
Mm. That, stress.
Stress is one of the things. Mm. And most of the time, stress is brought by lack of money, lack of, you know, things like that, that facilitate your everyday activities.
Dissatisfaction.
Dissatisfaction. And also some of those things, ambition.
Mm.
Yeah? Mm. If things are not working your way.
Mm.
That's why it brings me back to what I said, what's your temperament? Are you a sanguine? Are you...
So, Pablo, you're trying to tell me red is based on tribes?
No. It has nothing. That's just stereotypical. Mm. That's you can't base anger on stereotype. Nobody will ever tell you that this tribe is angry, that this tribe. No way. It's personal.
Mm.
Yeah, because there are some tribes which are stereotyped to be soft spoken, but the day you find one who's as, there are some who are as bitter lemon.
Yeah.
So you learn on that one. Eh? Mm. That one, you just look at them and you see your last funeral rites when they are angry. But for me, I think it all depends on how could you deal with the anger.
Before we go to that, there's some of the reasons why they say anger is a good thing sometimes.
Mm.
So without feelings of anger, we wouldn't take a stand against unfairness or injustice. Mm. Do you believe with that?
Yeah, I'll tell you this for a fact.
Like, I can't believe Pablo did this to me.
Yes.
I'm angry, but I'm not going to fight.
Yeah, I'll tell you one thing.
Mm.
I have a friend who wanted to get married, but he wasn't sure. And I asked him, have you had an argument with this lady?
Mm.
He said, no. He said, everything is okay. I said, everything has never been okay until you know this person's level of anger. So I told him, you go and intentionally make this person angry and see if you can live with their degree of anger.
Wait, you gave him that advice?
Yes.
Why did you do that, Pablo?
Yes, even me, I intentionally made, when my wife was still angry, I made sure that I first intentionally get her angry to see, can I live with this anger? If I can live with it, then our relationship is okay. So it's a yardstick. It's one of the yardsticks you use to measure a relationship. Mm. Yeah. If your closest friend does something that's bad to you, and you easily tell them, you see, when I'll tell you, I like people who tell the truth. A person come and tell me, Pablo, you know what? I don't like your jokes. They're not funny. In fact, I even brought my girlfriend and she chucked me because of you. You know, like I like the bitter truth. That's why it's called bitter.
Truth.
Mm. The because it's
sour.
It's
but
sour,
you have to take it anyway.
Yeah, and then again also the when people are angry, they'll tell you the truth. They'll tell you the truth. That's why if a person who watches movies, when you see these movies, they are called investigative movies, or when guys are in court, especially the Americans tell where they have a jury. Do you notice that the lawyer always wants to get he wants to get them
the one they're cross-examining
angry.
Yes.
He wants to get them bitter so that they can tell the truth. The truth always comes out when people are angry.
They go like, I must appeal to you, Pablo,
yes.
You're lying.
Yeah.
On this day and this day, you were like this.
And I've seen the politicians on TV. When they're angry, that's when they say, that's when you see their real feelings, that's when they express their true colors. And that helps you understand how to deal with them.
Chilling.
So, Pablo, how can we control anger? Finally, we are here. Let me read for you some of the steps, and then you will also add on. First of all, think before you speak. When you're angry, I don't think you're in the right state of mind to say anything.
So the question is, if you're not in the right
state
of
mind,
mind
yeah.
to think of anything. Mm. And that means you're not even thinking.
No, you have to think before you speak. No, Pablo, Katito, don't confuse me. Don't get me angry. Don't get me angry, my brother. No, like, you have to think, like, seriously, before you say anything. Maybe it would piss me off. And I really don't want to say anything at that state of mind. You know, like, because the trigger is kicking in. Let me take up some time, I cool down, and then we talk. How about that? I think, and that's one of the methods I use whenever I have a fight with my family members, because I love them so preciously. What I do when they piss me off, I walk away.
But if there's no place to go?
I go lock myself in a room. Come on, there's always a place to go.
But if you're in a lift and just jumped.
Somebody can't be that mean to piss you off and then lock you up in a room. And then the second one says, once you're calm, express your anger, exactly what I was saying. You believe that people can actually calm down when they're angry.
That's quite interesting. Calmness in the midst of anger.
After the anger is gone, anger can go.
Chilling.
So at times, you want to find out, am I the cause of this? Or there's an underlying factor? Maybe there's something else that could be the problem. Maybe this person is going through some emotional stress, so I'm the shock absorber. Secondly, you want to know what is the issue at hand? What's the issue at hand? And what's my level of involvement? How much have I contributed to the conflict? And then in there you want to know, do I take the blame? Because the main problem is that when people don't want to own up to mistakes. And the moment you don't want to own up, then that's the beginning of your anger hiking, So I think for me it's all about, like you said, that's why we have 2 ears and 1 mouth. Let's listen before I speak.
Okay, now Pablo, we are wrapping it up. It's time up, almost time up. We have to leave for now. But other things I wanted to tell you about, go get exercise, take some exercise, then take some time out, which you totally don't believe in.
No, I have no problem with walking. Actually, that's the best thing. Just to walk
time
away.
Out. Just like the white people, time out.
Yeah, just take a walk.
And time out is not only for kids. And then there's also identify possible solutions. If not, go and seek advice, and then you go for help. So Pablo, the first part, this is where we end it from here, because the second part is roaming on this horizon. We have to talk about, let me ask you something. This question you have to answer on this other part coming up next week. You're gonna tell me about your first break. When did your first break come?
Thought breakfast.
No, your first your break first in your
break,
career.
Like breakfast.
Okay. Yeah, guys, thank you very much for staying with me and Pablo. Pablo is still here with me. We're still at Deep and Sip. I want to thank Isaac, Union Tunnel, and Henry for the incredible work. These guys are doing a magnificent job. I also want to thank my designer, that's Quasi Classic, located on Mandegear. See you next week.
Next week on Chilling.
I used to be in almost all the clubs. I was in drama, I was in the economics club, I was in Scripture Union, I was in I was the senior spectator. They would rather leave a substitute and take me to spectator. When I went to Boma Primary School, the second day at school, they told me that I used to have Maradona shoes. So the teacher told me, tomorrow don't come back with the shoes. So I said, why? And say, if you wear shoes, what will the headmaster do?
Just give me an impression.
We shall not accept any kind of intimidation from the government of
Jakorachi. Message is so easy.
Chilling.
My name is Drago and I'm the host of Chilling, and I'm asking you, my friend, to keep the love coming on YouTube, Facebook and Twitter. That is Chilling UBC TV.